Good morning. I'm Vanessa Martinez from KWST Television, and I'm at the San Dimas Art Show and Sale, where artists get to show and present their unique and inspirational artwork. Hi, I'm Vanessa Martinez with KWST Television, and I'm with
Mian Situ.
Where are you from, Mian?
Well, originally I'm from China, but I've been in North America for 35 years. Well, that's one of the series subjects I paint. I paint a couple different subjects. The Chinese American immigrant, and the cowboy, and sometimes the Native American. So that is, a fighter, a cowboy. So that the model inspired me, and he have a wonderful feature, and so he posed for me. So I name it fighter. Yeah.
So this is a model wearing a cowboy outfit?
Yeah, wearing the cowboy outfit, yeah.
And why the specific look did you?
Western subject is always inspired me for some of my paintings. But I told you, I cover different subjects. That's one of the subjects I like. I like the, you know, the spiritual and their look is so inspirational. Yeah.
Now, what is this, acrylic or oil painting?
It's oil. This one's oil. Yes.
And what about this piece, big piece right here?
Yeah, that is one of my major pieces. Early Chinese immigrant to United States. The scene is from San Francisco, 100 years ago, and I happen to come from the same area where most of the early Chinese immigrants came. Yes, and in China, I mean. So when I was in China, when I was a child, I heard a lot of story about those Chinese immigrants. What they do in American United States, we call United States Golden Mountain at the time. Yeah, so I heard a lot of story, but I just didn't imagine myself one day will be in America. So that is the story based on some historical photo record. And so early Chinese immigrants, they settled down in Chinatown because the language problem and the culture, all those were new to them. So they stayed together in Chinatown. So they keep the same lifestyle and they dress almost the same like what they did in China. So I'm very familiar with that. And also, I've been in North America for 30 years, so I have both experience in China and in America. So, I should have a little history, and with the research, so I can, I feel quite comfortable to this, paint this subject. All my career, oil is the only media I use. Yeah, that's been my whole life. Yeah, I love oil.
How long have you been painting?
Well, since I was a boy and when I was about 13. I went into the college in China and I studied 6 years in college and I taught there for another 6 years before I moved to America. And after I moved here, so I always been in art business.
Now let's move on to the side of the of the wall. Now, explain to me this inspiration that you...
Well, those are the cowboy subject, of course. These are kind of the people moved to the west to settle down. So I named it almost home. So they, after long day journey, and they almost reached their destination. So I like the light and the evening when they are tired from the journey. This guy is wiping his the sweat, and you know, they get ready to for the night. So
I'm noticing your strokes on your brushes is, and I've also noticed how the faces of these men are not so focused. Why is your, do you have a meaning towards your stroke, or is this a form of style?
For this composition, it's quite important that I put everything together to get the atmosphere. It's more important than the face in here, in this painting. The evening, the cloud on the sky, the sun hitting the wagon, and the red color in front of the bright wagon. So all those is the light effects in the painting. It create the atmosphere that romantic at the same time.
So you're focusing on the atmosphere, the lighting of that evening.
Yeah, the lighting is wonderful.
Now let's talk about this one. I see they're trying to grab a dog, or what's going on here?
This was happened in my friend's ranch, and so we visited his ranch at the time when he had the round up at the time. So we spent a whole day there, and I like those activities. And when they actually they are real cowboy. Not like those actors, and you know, it's real. They are real working at the ranch. So I just, you know, like the action and the you know, the job they're performing. That's very inspiration.
I'm with Angela Koenig. Angela, your paintings are beautiful. Please tell me your technique, the style of these paintings.
Okay, well, so this year for this show, I decided I wanted to, since we work on California images, I wanted to do California Zen. So everything in my booth this year is about the water in California and kind of a peaceful Zen feeling that we often have as we go to the shore here in California. I started with the concept of the water, and all of my pieces, I try to really work on integrating the animals or the birds into their environment. And so to do that, I really have to start with the background and then incorporate the animal into the background. So all of the top pieces are done in acrylic, but they start off as a watercolor. So I have all kinds of crazy colors in the background, and then I start to pull, and have the images basically emerge out of the background, which makes them have depth and also has a lot of movement, hopefully, in the pieces. The bottom pieces here are done in what we call a monotype, which is actually inks on a plate, is an acrylic plate that I press through a printing press multiple times to create the background. And I create a whole series of these backgrounds, and then I look at what I have and I turn them upside down and all different ways, and I start to see images emerge, and the images literally come out of the background.
I'm with Robert Rodriguez. Robert, tell me a little bit about your artistic background.
Well, I went to art school. I went to Chouinard Art Institute, which has now become Cal Arts in Newhall. After school, I became an illustrator. And I've been an illustrator, even now I am. Just the last few years, I've started to do fine art for galleries. And it's been an experience to try to figure out what it is I'd really like to paint. I mean, you can see there are a lot of different styles here, because as an illustrator, you have to change up. Every job is different. But as a fine artist, you should actually focus in on something. So I'm trying to figure out what it is I want to do, and that's why everything's so different here. I've always painted very precisely, very tight, more in keeping with these orange crate labels. But I've been trying to loosen up a little bit, and so you can see the textures in the background.
Yeah, tell me a little bit about this one right here.
This is a Blackfoot Indian war shirt. It's an actual shirt that I saw in a museum, which was an interesting process for me anyway. It's something called cold wax medium, and it's beeswax mixed with resins and oils, and you mix it with the paint and you put it on, and then once one layer dries, you can put another layer on, and then you can remove that second layer in parts so that you see what's underneath.
From the original art show, we have here Richard Meyer. Richard, please tell me your experience from all these years.
Oh, that's a long time here. For 43 years I've been coming here. And every year it gets more interesting. You can see the improvement over the years, you know. We have a lot of good artists come every year, and we enjoy it here. I enjoy it. I live in Glendora, of course, close by. And should I tell you how old I am?
So you work, what do you specifically work on?
Oh, most of mine are sculpture. I do painting, but most of the time I do sculpture. And I find out sculpture takes a lot more work than a painter. Painter paints a painting and he just puts a frame on it and finishes it. The sculpture, you have to make a mold, make a wax, then take it to the foundry, the county cast it, then you have to mount it on a base, then you have to, and it's a lot more involved, and it costs more money too, because the foundry costs. The latest one is the one with the fairies on it. And it has seven fairies, and I call it Fairyland. Just lately, I've been taking a workshop where I have where they have a model comes in, and everybody's painting the model. I sculpt the model. They're painting or making a drawing of it, and so I have all these sculptures, because I do one a week, and in a year you have 52 sculpture pieces there. So I thought, what am I going to do? So I put them all, seven of them together, and make one statue of the fairies. I add wings to them, and then when I first started, I thought, well, make them, you know, you got to come up with a good idea. I thought I'd just put them on a straight pole, but then I thought it would make it be easier to make a nice curve to it. It would make a better design. You know, that's just, the funnest thing in art is coming up with the idea. The rest is all labor making it, you know. And then the hardest thing is selling it. Most of the stuff I used to do was horses and cowboys and Indians and all different things. But there's so much out there that ideas that come from, you know, like one thing leads to another, you know. I just keep making things. Because I make, I only have six pieces here, but I probably got about 400 pieces at home.
Hi, I'm with Larry Hemrick. Please tell me, these paintings are from far away. They look like photos. They're beautiful.
Thank you. When I first started doing pastels was probably less than 3 years ago. And I had always done oils and was never that satisfied with the results. And a set of pastels that had been given to me, I finally picked them up and started working with them. And I couldn't believe what I saw in front of me just absolutely blew me away. And I knew I was onto something. Most of my images all come from my hiking. I'm from Palm Springs. I do a lot of hiking in the local mountains. So my subject matter comes from, you know, my hiking experiences.
Hi guys, I am with Dino Mahaffey. Dino, please tell me the process of this beautiful art. Piece of work.
First it's done in clay. The whole thing is done in clay. Then the clay goes to, we take the clay to the foundry, the bronze foundry, and what they do is they cut sections off the legs and whatever is protruding too much to make a mold off of, make separate molds, And then they make a wax of all these pieces and wax off of the mold. And then they, because it's a rubber mold, so they can't pour hot bronze in it. So then they take the wax parts and they dip them as concrete, like a cement, until it builds up a big casing. Then they have vent holes for hot air to vent and hollow at the bottom, so that they heat that up. When it's hard encased, they heat it up and all the wax melts out of it. Then it has the void of this inside of that casing. Then they pour molten hot bronze into that casing, and then it becomes a bronze, and then they just break away all the cement. I used to box when I was young and train fighters. So I had this inspiration one time. I said, I'm going to do some boxers, because I'd never done boxers before. So I started with this guy, like he's just coming into the ring and warming up. You know, he's just, you know how they come out with their robe on? This guy here, the one over here, is the same guy. And halfway through the fight, and the trainer is talking to him. He's asking the trainer, what should I do? See the confused look on his face. And the trainer is telling him to go to the body. That's why he's got his fist like this, hand to show you. He's saying, go to the body, kid. Okay, so that's what this story is about. And so then from that to this one is where he didn't listen to the trainer and lost the fight. So now he's all depressed because he's lost the fight. He's got the towel over his head and still got the wraps on his hands. They took the gloves off and he's got the wraps there. They wrap their hands first, you know. And so that is him losing because he didn't listen to what he was saying to do.
My name is Walter Marodine Bramzode. I'm the owner of Square Eye Gallery in Claremont. And this year they asked me to be a jury for the show of the 43rd annual San Dimas Art Festival.
Is this your first time being a judge for this show?
Yes. This is the first time. I'd done some other juries, but this is the first time they asked me to do it. So
being a judge, how do you make the right decision in the right art? Which artist should take the place?
I'm always looking for originality and the perspective of the artist, because these are all on location. So it all depends when the artists choose the angle of their subject, how they approach it, and the technique, basically. So, and I'm looking for the strong technique and, you know, negative space. So which part of the painting he or she leaves it alone, that's very important for me. So I don't like to see a painting completely done, because then becomes photo. So I want the paintings to be a painting instead of something realistic like a photography.
Well, that's a wrap. Thank you for watching. Reporting from San Dimas Art Show and Sale, I'm Vanessa Martinez, KWST TV.